I am an American. This is my land as well as it belongs to the prosecutors and the judges. I have my rights as well, and I am proud of this American heritage and the principles that it embodies. And I'm proud to be a part of this fight for freedom. And anyone who would ask me to lay these principles aside, I say to them, in the language that I know best, two words, shove it.
Harvard Law School, I am pleased to present Mr. Larry Flynt.
Thank you very much. You know, there's nothing of literary merit that qualifies me to be speaking here today. But since I've been dragged through most of the courts, in prison, shot, paralyzed, defending the First Amendment, I figured I could give you a view from the trenches.
Hustler publisher Larry Flynt, his wife Althea, his brother Jimmy, and Hustler official Al Van Schaik are being tried on charges of engaging in organized crime and pandering obscenity.
Flynt obscenity trial is in essence a trial of definitions. What constitutes contemporary community standards towards sex? And ultimately, what constitutes obscenity? The fight over those definitions began in earnest today.
The laws are not too difficult to enforce. All you need to put the pornographer where he belongs in jail is a good prosecutor, a willing prosecutor, and a capable court.
Can't call it good, dirty fun when you're talking about all types of unnatural sex acts, many of the things I never even heard of before I studied that magazine. You can't talk about good, dirty fun when you're attacking every institution in this country through the magazine. When you attack Santa Claus, a tradition in this country that's been in existence for years and years and years. That isn't good, dirty fun. That's attacking, through sex, everything decent in this country.
I can tell you why they singled me out. And I start studying some of my Hustler issues very close, and not just the photo spread, study a lot of the humor and cartoons and the satire. We publish a great deal of social and political satire. I mean, it's really mean. It's really biting. But we figure, you know, that freedom of the press is only important if it's offensive. If we're not going to offend anybody, we don't need protection of the First Amendment.
I don't think we're infringing on other people's rights when we ask that this material is not available to people who really don't have any desire to see this. They're humiliated by it. Men as well as women now are being humiliated by this, and I wish I could give some examples on the air.
A motorcycle gang who is raping this blonde, and she is really enjoying it.
Well, how do you know she's enjoying it? And I don't know what cartoon
I'm
you're talking about.
At
you
the
sure
expression.
You've been reading Hustler?
Yes, I'm there. It's
you
in
know,
the same issue where
think...
the little girl was going to be attacked. It's in the same issue.
You know, I'm beginning to think you get off on Hustler magazine. You're making it such a crusade.
No, I've only bought one, Larry.
A Cincinnati jury has found Larry Flynt, publisher of the men's magazine Hustler, guilty of pandering obscenity and engaging in organized crime. He was sentenced to up to 25 years in jail and fined $11,000. The organized crime charge was based on the grounds that four individuals in the corporation conspired in the alleged criminal act. The other individuals were found innocent. Flynt said he would appeal.
When they convicted Larry, and remember, we got it reversed and the statute declared unconstitutional, but at the time of Larry's sentence, I gotta imagine this scene. The jury comes down with a guilty verdict on Larry. They acquit the rest of them. The next thing the DA goes, wait, before you sentence him, we have another indictment. Because Larry put out this brochure, The War, The Real Obscenity, and he had pictures of guys blown up in the Vietnam War, and then he had a picture of a voluptuous woman, and he goes, what's the real obscenity, war or beautiful women?
Which is the greater obscenity, war or pornography?
I have a hard time answering the questions.
And the judge says, you have anything to say before I pass the sentence? And Larry goes, you haven't made one intelligent decision in this entire trial. Now think about this. I'm a young lawyer sitting over there going, oh, yes. You know, I mean, these are the things you want to hear people tell judges, right? He goes, you haven't made an intelligent decision yet in this trial. I don't expect one now. Let's do it, right? So anyway, he gives him 7 to 25 years. And that really made Larry an overnight sensation because the world couldn't believe that somebody could publish a magazine and get 25 years in prison for it.
I knew he would give me everything he could.
How about being sent to jail right away?
Well, they feel very much threatened by Hustler magazine and by me because it's one thing they can't control.
Larry Flynt has been in jail since last Tuesday when he was convicted of pandering obscenity. Today, an appeals court ruled Flynt could be released on $55,000 bail while he appeals and he's out.
I'm sure every one of you are just as proud of being an American as I am. We're the strongest country in the world today, only because we are the freest country in the world today. And I don't want any American anywhere to ever forget that that strength lies in our principles to be free.
I think I really had to stand in a courtroom in Cincinnati, Ohio, and listen to a judge sentence me to 25 years in prison before I realized that freedom of expression could no longer be taken for granted. And by that time, I was already caught up in the free speech movement, and I've devoted half my life to trying to improve the most basic freedom that we have. And that is, you know, freedom of expression. The culture we live in today was born into a society where you could take your individual rights and civil liberties for granted. So they don't understand what the country would be like without the First Amendment because they haven't experienced it. And to them, it's just legal jargon, you know. They take all of their freedoms for granted, that they're going to have them and it's never going to end. But don't forget, Hitler was elected. There was no coup. He was elected by the people. You see what a monster that he turned out to be. He was elected by people who thought they were doing the right thing, you know. It's like people who elected George Bush.